creates money. There's an assumption about money creation. So the first assumption about money creation is that there is a bank, that there's a commercial bank waiting for deposits. There's a commercial bank waiting for what? Deposits. That means this bank is available. It's waiting for people to come, put money into the bank. Do you understand?
Yes.
Two, there is an individual who wants to save money. Do we get it? So this is the bank. So this is the individual who has money with him. He needs to save money. That's the second assumption, right? The third assumption, there is an individual who wants to borrow money. His mind is about loan. He's thinking of loan. So these are the first three assumptions about money creation. So the bank is already there, waiting for an individual with money to come. Yes or no? So this individual will pay money to the bank. The bank has the money already. Let's assume we have the bank. We have the bank. That's an assumption. So the saver is coming with $10,000. Or let's say it's coming with $100, and say $100, okay? $100. It's going to take it where? To the bank. So now the bank has what? $100. Yes or no?
Yes.
So now the bank has $100. So let's say we have the saver, the bank, the saver here, and the bank here, right?
Yes.
So the saver has placed $100 into the bank. So the saver has $100. There's this individual who needs a loan. Where is he going to get the loan from? The bank. So the bank is going to give a loan of $100 to the individual to pay at a later date. Yes or no? Stop writing, please. To pay at a later date. So what happens here? The individual will take a loan. And what is the loan? An amount of money you collected from the bank that you have to pay back with interest. Yes or no? You have to pay back with what? Interest. So the individual goes to the bank for a loan of $100. Maybe the interest rate is $2 or 2%. So that individual has to pay 2% on the interest at the time it has to pay back the loan. Yes or no? So the fourth assumption is that the bank gave loan to an individual, with interest. Do you get it? So that individual has taken the loan with interest. Do you understand what you hear? So the interest of 2%.
No, mister.
Is 100 multiplied by 2 over 100. We get this. No, 2% of 2%, yeah. 2 over 100, right? 2 over 100 multiplied by 100. So that means 2. So this individual that has borrowed money will pay back $102. Yes or no?
Yes, yes.
So the bank before doesn't have nothing. Now the bank is having how much?
102.
And that individual that needs his own money, when he comes back, how much is he going to get? Do you understand? So the bank has created additional $2. This is how banks create money. Is it clear?
Yes.